What's up, everybody? Tile cleaning today. My first stop. This was a referral from another client that I did some tile cleaning for about a month ago. The way I acquired this job is I was out and about and I was wearing one of my shirts that had the list of services on the back of it, and she's like, "Oh, you do carpet and tile cleaning?" I was like, "Yeah, absolutely." And you know, my shirt basically opened the conversation for me, and it turned into a tile job at her house, a carpet job at a friend's house, and now this tile job at another house. So a shirt that cost me $10 got me 3 jobs. Pretty awesome. This floor isn't too bad. The floor is only 2 years old. There is some missing grout in some areas, which I went over with her and showed her. You can see a difference in color. And then so far I found 3 tiles that are loose. And the way you find out if they're loose, because you can't actually really see that they are, is you'll get a hollow sound when you step on it, or if you sit there and knock on the tile that you heard a different sound from, you'll know what I'm talking about. So it's not going to affect the cleaning or anything in any way in this situation. It's just the tile separated a little bit from the foundation beneath. You've got a little air pocket or whatever there, and so when you knock on it, you can hear that it's loose. So I just brought it to her attention, so that way down the road, if she happens to walk over it and notice that sound difference, she's not wondering what is going on here. That, and if somebody's never had their tile surface cleaned, you know, doesn't know what to expect, you definitely want to make sure you go over everything with them, because if you don't and they find that shortly after you leave, which tends to be pretty common, you know, because now they're starting to look at their floor and enjoying the cleanliness of it more than they normally would, because they just invested in keeping it up and all that. So those things they'll start to notice more. And you know, obviously it wasn't your fault, but how are they supposed to know that? So that's the thing you want to do, is when you're inspecting your tile surface, you want to look for damaged grout, hairline cracks in the tile or grout lines, and any loose tiles. So I found those 2 so far. Haven't heard any other ones or noticed any when I stepped on them, but told her that I would let her know if I came across any other ones, so she's aware. A little dirty, but it's not in bad shape. It's mainly just the grout, you know, grout's hard to keep up. That's normal. So I'm just scrubbing it to give it a little extra. It doesn't necessarily need it, just ample dwell time would have done the trick for this one, but this way I can give you guys a little something to watch, because everybody loves the CRB, right? BDS crew, I've already actually rinsed all this off. I'm just kind of doing a little extra pass over the main areas. just to be sure. And so you guys can see a little bit of rinsing with the spinner tool. So I can get in that little area right there. But that's it so far. grout looks right here. This area is already drying. So this tile is going to, the grout's going to look nice when it's all dried out. Next up is sealing the grout. Look at that, nice and clean. It's all dried out, ready to go for the seal. So I'm using this roller. When you buy these, you get one with a thin wheel and you get one with a thicker wheel, depending on the size of the grout lines you're dealing with. So this one's for the 1/8 inch grout lines, which is perfect for this. I just got this a while ago. Should have got one a long time ago. Speeds it up a little bit compared to, you know, scooting on my butt and doing it with basically the same thing, but just a smaller bottle. So when the grout joints aren't that deep, it's also a little tough to keep the roller into it. But the benefit of doing it this way and not trying to get it on the tile is, depending on the product you use, you can end up with a sealer haze on the tile, and you'll get called right back for that if the client notices it, or if it dries, you know, that unevenly and causes a sealer haze. This is not a stone, so it's not going to absorb. So if I was to do that, I run the risk of sealer haze. So seems like tedious work, especially when the grout lines are like this. You know, but it is what it is. In order to do it, you gotta go like this, or of course I feel like if you were to spray it across the whole thing and then microfiber mop everything afterwards to get the excess up, in the long run you'd just be using more product. Is it quicker? Probably a little bit. But if you're using high-end sealer, you're probably not going to be fond of doing it that way, because the seal that I'm using is not cheap, because I want to provide a product that's going to work well and last them the maximum amount of time. So that way, in between cleans, I know it's protected. So just wanted to go over that with you guys and show you. So I'm going to continue this on. As you can see, it's nice and dark again because of the sealer. This is a water-based sealer. The water portion of it is the carrier. Water will evaporate and the seal will cure into the grout. So with that being said, thank you guys for watching this video. This is my first job. About ready to go on to the next one.